so nice. It's so pretty.
Spain. It's finally settling in that I have left the concrete jungle behind to pursue the Sufjan Stevens European summer in a medieval city. On July 17th, I traveled internationally for the first time. This trip is going to be full of milestones of growing up and learning, so I'm glad it started off with a big one, semi-successfully.
I didn't think this trip was going to be so bad because it's not that long of a flight, one transfer, but oh my god. I feel like the first half was fine. Second half, I was like, don't fucking cry. I wasn't like actually about to cry because I knew it was fine. I was just like, bruh, it's like hot and I'm like, don't know where I am exactly.
I had to transfer flights from Madrid to Santiago, and in that time, I didn't have that much of a gap. I didn't have that much time in between. And then what happened was, like, I barely made the flight, but then there weren't that many people on the same connecting flights. It was like, I think I recognized one person, but maybe there were more, I just don't know. I was like one of the last passengers on the plane. Luckily, I made it, and then once I got out, My one luggage was nowhere to be found, so then I went to the help desk. I recognized some other people from my flight there, and they told me it's gonna be here at 5 p.m. today from New York, and we may be able to deliver it to where you're staying. We might not, so I might have to go back and pick it up. The taxi costs 21 euros to get here to this campus. Right now, the exchange rate is like basically the same for euros and dollars. It's about 1-to-1, so I don't have to do like extra math, which is nice. On the drive here, I was just like, I think after that experience in the airport, waiting so long, and then I'm like there for a couple of hours, and the airport was empty when I was leaving. I was like, this is a little creepy. Just any space where it's completely empty in a public area, I always find like a bit creepy. I prefer it to be more dense because then you know there's like life and someone is not gonna like jump scare you. But obviously it's the airport, so it's fine. And I was just like, oh my god, I don't know like what I got myself into. I think that was like when I kind of started to process that I'm actually like here, when I was in the taxi and I started seeing all the new things, and I'm like there's like beautiful mountains, landscapes. And then when we got to pass through Santiago itself, I was like, okay, the architecture is really cool. The most recent trip I went on was to Puerto Rico, and it reminds me a bit of like the old town vibe, where it's like not skyscrapers, they're more like oldish architecture, or what I imagine to be old architecture, because I don't truly know what that is. So I finally get to campus, I get dropped off by the taxi, and I'm like, okay, now which building do I go to? And I'm trying to figure out the building, and then I walk around for like 20 to 30 minutes trying to ask people for help, and they don't know it either. So I'm like, am I truly just in the wrong place? I don't know. And then finally someone is like, hey, I they see I'm lost clearly, and they help me, which is great of them. And they even like, my phone number wasn't working, I don't know why. I need to get the SIM card thing figured out. I thought my phone would work, so I got a text from T-Mobile saying it should work and look great, but whatever. So they called the dorm office for me, and then I was like, yeah, I'm here. And they're like, oh my god, okay, great. And then they were super nice. And now I'm here, and this room kind of slaps. I was like, oh my god, what did I get myself into? It's so hot, and I'm like wearing my sweater because I didn't want to pack in my luggage, and none of my luggage is here, but like I have my toiletries. I did not pack an extra change of clothes, which sucks. That was such a mistake because it's super hot here, but whatever, what are you gonna do? This room slaps though. This window, call me by your name, who? Entrance, closet space, so much closet space. This is literally so much bigger than my apartment and room in New York, but you know, obviously that's a really weird place to compare it to. Oh my god, this room is huge! Okay. Damn. That's the one light bulb up there. Here's a one desk shelf and another desk. And here's my Call Me By Your Name window. Oh, to see without my eyes. First time that you kissed me.
Boundless by the time I cry. Me in 1980s Italian summer. Who? I know I'm not in Italy, I'm in Spain, but that's the only like reference point I have. And then I was watching Before Midnight, the last movie in the Before series last night, and I was like, is it just a thing where writers own like nice, beautiful homes in these like cottagecore-esque places and just invite people and have like nice, luxurious dinners all the time in summers? Because that's what this window makes me feel like I'm able to do. And I have a solo room, which is really great because in Prague I'm going to have a roommate, and nothing wrong with having a roommate, obviously. But it is nice to have your own space, and for 1 month, and like I paid a little extra for the one single room. Okay, so when I walked in, I was like, damn, oh my god, this is so much better than I thought. I have a bathroom in here. Oh my god, that's amazing. I have my own bathroom. Never heard of that. I'm gonna shower. I'm gonna just get ready to eat because I had some food yesterday, but I want more, obviously. Closet space. My bed was made for me, which is cool. There's a little body mirror over there. There's a desk here, a desk here. I guess this is supposed to be for two people, but maybe they removed one of the beds. And then a shelf up there, which is sink. They gave me sheets and a blanket. If I had read my welcome packet more closely, I would have known that, but I didn't know that until now. So, until I read the packet in the airport, actually. But it's all good, because it's in my luggage and I don't even have my luggage right now. I don't even want to get in with these like disgusting airport clothes. Yeah, I'm just gonna get ready, but look at this window.
It's to die for.
I saw someone from down there like opening their window and standing. I'm like, no, that cannot be the dorm. That is too nice. That cannot be the dorm, but it literally is. I was like here, down there, and then I saw someone with the window up here. Living my European dream, huh? Oh my god, that's crazy. Okay, so like that's what the windows look like. Also, something that's kind of alarming is how like deserted this campus feels. Maybe like, I mean, the dining area was pretty full, but maybe it just has to do with like the time of day. It's Monday, first day of the semester. I missed my placement exam right now for the Spanish language class, but I'll just make it up because the flights were too expensive on the day before. Okay, I'm all showered up. I have to wear the same clothes again. It's okay because I'm supposed to get my luggage by like 5 or 6 p.m. today, I believe. Let's just say the shower was great, the pressure was great, but it wasn't a hands-free experience, which I know like some places have these like handheld showers, but it was like, you know, gotta get accustomed to everything. Oh my god, I'm so happy with my room. It's so big, so well lit. There's like one light bulb in the middle, but at nighttime, I'm assuming I'm not gonna care that much for 1 month. You gotta hold the hose part. I'm used to a few different types of showers, so this isn't that bad. I just have to figure out how not to make the water go everywhere. It would just be easier to do that. I'm gonna go nourish myself, eat some food, and try to figure out what the heck is going on about classes and what I need to do as a new student here. I feel like I'm one with nature, just being able to have that huge window. I was worried the window situation would not be great, but it has been, luckily, so far. Is this the new vlogging setup? That's kind of cute. Okay, I have to get food. I'm taking this camera out with me. I don't know if I just want to bring out my Sony camera just yet because of, you know, I'm trying to make friends. I'm trying to sit with new people, figure out who the heck is in my cohort. And we'll all make friends. This is my first day in Spain. My first totally solo abroad trip. But of course I'm with the school, so it's not solo. But we're gonna see. All right, someone has soy milk and oat milk. That means this should be good. This is in the communal fridge. My view from my room. I went to the Office of International Courses to figure out what to do because I missed the first day of class. I missed the placement exam. The head of the office was super nice and she was like, don't worry, we'll figure it out tomorrow. Just take the exam tomorrow. To figure out where the building was, I ran into two people when I asked them and they were so kind to lead me to the actual office itself.
and then also like just show me around the campus and show me around the town right here a little bit. Something about this place gives me the vibe that I'm like stuck in an olden age, even though I'm obviously not. I have my phone, my internet is working, I have to get a SIM card still. But I think these, like, I'll just generally call this type of area like a Call Me By Your Name-esque place. It's like you relax, you're slow, because I was asking them, what do you guys do? And they were like, we just go to class, we chill, we walk around, we eat food, like, and they eat in the dining hall for Monday through Friday.
New York's outdoor seating could never.
Like, it's very lax. I wasn't expecting this, but I'm glad it is this because it's definitely a change of pace from living in New York to here. I went to the grocery stores, I scoped them out, and there is very promising vegan pantry staples. So I do have a kitchen downstairs, but I don't think I'll be using it that much. And I think there's even a place where you can buy like different quantities of food. So I don't want like a whole bag of lentils. I can just get like, you know, a cup or whatever. I'm pretty sure that's what that is.
No. I thought this was Aesop gold, psyllium husk. It's not.
It's a bit difficult to read the labels right now because I haven't memorized the words for things that are not vegan yet.
Some of the vegan yogurt options. Not buying this, but it's like plastic in a cloth bag.
Okay, we made it to the plant milk section. I'm kind of leaning towards this one.
I believe Target is an American company, and I literally bought the Target tote bag here all the way from the US. Bringing American capitalism with me wherever I go.
So I'm gonna go back out. My luggage still isn't here. It might not come today. I really hope it does because I have to go to class tomorrow and I don't have another outfit, so like that would just suck. If I don't have my clothes, maybe I should go buy a shirt and like shorts today. It's just such a waste. But these sweatpants are so hot, I don't necessarily need another shirt. Yeah, maybe I can buy something, I don't know. I'm enjoying my time here so far. I'm wondering if it's gonna get boring. I don't think so, because I'm only here for 1 month and I can always go on like day trips to other parts of Spain and even like Europe if I want to. So let's see what's happening. But so far, like, this is going really well. I hope the classes are not like so hard to the point where I'm like struggling a lot, but I obviously like I want to learn, that's why I'm here. So let's do that too. I quit smoking. It's around 9 p.m. here. Oh, I should change the time zone on my camera. Yeah, so it's 9:30 here. 9:30 at night. Do you see this natural sunlight still coming in? The sun is setting around 10:18 p.m. tonight. It's crazy. And it rises at 7:12 a.m. tomorrow. So the sunlight here is gonna be great. I believe my window faces north. I'm just guessing based on the position that the sun is sitting in right now. But still the light is like crazy good. So what was my first Spanish meal, you may ask? It was at the dining hall. Two pieces of bread with olive oil toasted on a pan, lettuce, tomato, and pickled asparagus. I didn't know asparagus could be pickled. Now I know. The pickled asparagus was so bad, but at least the sandwich was only like $4. I don't know, I guess it's like, even though that contents should say, yes, worth only €4 or $4. I know it would cost like way more in New York, so this was like great. And then I charged $1 for getting some steamed soy milk. I think I might do that again. I also just bought some soy milk from my, I bought some almond milk from the grocery store because that's what I prefer, oat or almond over soy. And then I ate two more pieces of bread with olive oil, which was good. It's just like the bread is like white bread. I don't like white bread. And I don't want to be like only eating bread. So I'm going to figure out some more like things. I can definitely go to the grocery store and get more things. Probably like order, make some pasta. Itsy things like that. I could even do like broccoli, steam it, you know. There is a kitchen downstairs, luckily. And after seeing the dinner selection, I'm like, okay, I will be needing to cook. And I also got a nail cutter, super random. And I'm sealing the night off with some chamomile tea.
which was $1. I realized you can drink the tap water, so I'm going to drink it instead of having to go to town, buy water, well, water bottle and bring it back. I'm just hoping my luggage is coming tomorrow because I do have class. Would be kind of sucky to have to wear like my clothes from the airport again for class, especially my sweatpants are so hot. And then if it doesn't come tomorrow, I'm definitely gonna have to like go buy something because it's sweaty. But I can hand wash my clothes tonight so that they aren't, okay, yeah. I can hand wash my shirt tonight. Okay. Yeah, let me just show you the groceries I got. Almond milk, dates, and water. I'm excited to try like the different brands of like plant stuff here and then see like what other ingredients are in them compared to like US brands out of curiosity and see if it tastes better. This one's really sweet, which it does say it has like 3.1 grams of sugar for every 100 milliliters. So how many milliliters are in a cup? I don't know, but this one was too sweet. I'm gonna try to find one that's less sweet. It's still good though, and I have to go put it in the community fridge. I did see Oatly as well. There's so many plant milks at this one place. I took a picture, so I'll try to go there again tomorrow and figure it out. I'm just like taking it one step at a time. It's been a pretty good experience so far. Maybe I'll have some dates tonight. When I get hungry, possibly, but I want to go to sleep soon so that I can like wake up tomorrow. But in New York, it's like 3:30 p.m. I'm not like that tired. Let's see what I get up to. This is what the room looks like at night. The lighting isn't horrendous for sure. It's pretty good. The mild buzzing went away from the light bulb, which is good. All I'd love to do is get ready for bed. I thought I was going to bed early. Now it's 11. Yeah, it's 11:20. I ended up doing some computer file organization stuff, some editing. Then tomorrow I have my first class. Class is 5 days a week, several hours, but I'm really excited to have like this language intensive. I gotta go downstairs to the community fridge to put my almond milk away because I opened it in the cafeteria and drank some and it was really delicious. And then I'm gonna get ready for bed and tomorrow the first day of class. All of my devices are losing battery. Wi-Fi, I couldn't get on either. I don't have any of my converters because that was my luggage. Hopefully my luggage comes tomorrow. Otherwise, I'll just ask people to like borrow their chargers. Just don't know anyone, so it feels very like using-ish, you know, using someone. But I don't know what to do because all my devices are dying soon. I do have like 3 camera batteries. Of course, it's like the one device I have. You might be my only survivor by tomorrow. Oh my god. Is it the street lights pointed in a narrow head leading us home? And I hope